So this is the beginning of my chosen journey. And this is where I was at the time. My daughter said to me, "Mom, if you're drinking again, I'm not coming home." And my husband told me, "I'm not making any excuses for you anymore." Boy, that last time drinking for me was like the perfect storm. The hangovers were really bad. Well, I'm just going to spare you all of the gory details. When I walked into the AA meeting that last morning on August 12, 1989, somehow I knew it was my last time. Alcoholics Anonymous had a revolving door for me before that time. I couldn't quit totally before. I would quit for a couple of weeks and sometimes really enjoy a couple of months, but I would always go back. You know, I could stop the behavior for a while, but I didn't change my thinking. And it's our thoughts that drive our behavior, which drive our actions, which produce our results. We have to change our thinking. And as I sat there in that last Alcoholics Anonymous meeting, I thought, what is next? There's got to be more than just drinking. And surely, maybe you're in this class because you're thinking, I know that there's more. I want more in my life. Maybe you're like I was. What's next? What's the more? Well, here's what I discovered. I stumbled on a book by a gentleman called Chuck C, called A New Pair of Glasses. And in that book, he says that we were chosen before the foundation of the universe by God. I was like, what? I was chosen before the foundation of the universe by God? The God of the universe knows my background. He knows my flaws. He knows all of my mistakes, my questionable past. And he still chose me? Oh, there has to be a reason for my life. He has to have a plan. And this is what I found out, is that God's plan for me was to understand what it meant to be chosen. It became my new identity. God began to the process of slowly changing my thinking and transforming my life from the old drinking Jan to the new Jan, who is free and fruitful. And the joy that I began to experience in my life, man, I couldn't make that happen outside of help from Jesus. I want that for you too. I want that same joy, that same power, and that freedom that is yours in Christ. You too can discover your chosenness, your identity in Christ in these next 6 weeks as we study together and expand the fruit of the Holy Spirit that's already within us. Our thinking's going to change, which will then change our behavior, and we'll begin getting different results. That's the more. You too will begin to experience the joy and transformation that understanding your identity in Christ holds for you.